I'm Raghavendra M. Shetty, Associate Professor, Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, Kendra Engineering College, Mangalore. This video is on Basic Electronics 18 ELN14 of VTU syllabus for first semester BE students. This is lecture number 3 of our first module, Semiconductor Diode and its Applications. In this video, we are going to explain what is Zener diode and what are the different breakdowns in the Zener diode. Zener diode is like an ordinary diode but always operated in a reverse bias mode. Practically, it is connected in a circuit in a reverse biased conditions. It is specially designed highly doped PN junction diode. When the reverse bias voltage is greater than the predetermined voltage, that is, if a Zener is of 5 volts, if a reverse voltage you apply, if it is more than 5 volts, Zener will get breakdown, and this voltage we call it as a Zener breakdown voltage. The breakdown happens in two types. One is Zener breakdown and second one is avalanche breakdown. We will see it one by one. Zener breakdown, this type of breakdown occurs when a reverse bias voltage is between 2 to 8 volts. So even at this low voltage, this breakdown occurs through an electric field intensity which is strong enough to break the covalent bonds. And this results in the formation of mobile electron hole pairs, which increases the flow of current across the device. This type of breakdown occurs normally for a highly doped diode. The diode is highly doped and its breakdown voltage is less, that is between 2 to 8 volts, and it exerts a large electric field, and this breakdown is majorly due to breaking of covalent bonds due to electric field. And this type of breakdown voltage decreases with the temperature. As the temperature increases, the valence electrons gains more energy and more number of covalent bonds are disrupted. So it is inversely proportional to the temperature. That is, Zener breakdown voltage decreases with the temperature. Avalanche breakdown. This type of breakdown occurs at the reverse bias voltage of magnitude 8 volts or higher. And this kind of Zener diodes are lightly doped and will have a large breakdown voltage. The minority charge carriers are the electrons, and they tend to collide with the electrons in the covalent bond by getting a kinetic energy and causes the covalent bond to break. As the reverse voltage increases, the kinetic energy of the electrons also increases. They move with the more acceleration, causing an increase in electron hole pairs. This avalanche breakdown is majorly due to the gain in the acceleration of kinetic energy of the electrons, making covalent bonds break. This avalanche breakdown also increases with the temperature. Here is just a comparison table between Zener breakdown and avalanche breakdown. Zener breakdown is due to intensive electric field, and avalanche breakdown is due to collision of charge carriers, that is electrons, with adjacent covalent bonds. Second point, it occurs at a Zener voltage below 6 volts to 8 volts, and avalanche breakdown occurs at a Zener voltage, Zener reverse voltage, more than 8 volts. It is negative temperature. Zener breakdown is a negative temperature coefficient, that is, it decreases with the temperature. and avalanche breakdown increases with the temperature. The VI curve is sharp at breakdown, that is, it takes a sudden breakdown, and in avalanche breakdown, VI curve is slowly, is not sharp. Thanks for watching.